Dancing with the Stars continued its 27th season by honoring the city that never sleeps. New York City Night followed a stressful two-night premiere event that ended with the elimination of stand-up comic Nikki Glaser. There's going to be a double elimination in week two. Based on these New York performances, so which Big Apples were delicious and which were rotten to the core? Well, if you were looking for a clear frontrunner to emerge after the week one tie between the top of the judges' leaderboard, we didn't quite get it. This week there were three celebs on top. Once again, Tinashe was one of them, dominating the dance floor with a futuristic Argentine tango full of some of the night's most difficult and death-defying tricks. So if nothing else, she has emerged as one of the most ambitious performers of the season, but she was matched by two different stars this time around, so the season is as competitive as ever, maybe even more than we originally thought. Juan Pablo de Pace impressed the judges in week one with his salsa. This time, he transitioned a quick step and did even better, picking up nines from Carrie Ann Inaba and Bruno Tonioli and an 8 from Len Goodman, giving him a total of 26 out of 30. Milo Manheim got the very same scores from the same judges. For his own dramatic change of pace, he traveled to Charleston in week two by way of the Manhattan subway after his cha-cha in week one. But while that trio owned the top of the leaderboard, that stickler Goodman saved his highest score of the season so far for model Alexis Ren, who danced an Argentine tango just like Tinashe did, but Goodman thought it was the best dance of the season so far and gave her his first 9. But Inaba Antonioli gave her 8s, so her total score of 25 fell just short of the top spot. That might be because of a momentary wardrobe malfunction during her routine. That darn tearaway tutu just wouldn't cooperate. But those celebs mostly excelled in week one as well. What about the contestants who were trying to redeem themselves? Chief among those was Joan Mobile, the dancer formerly known as grocery store Joan, the Bachelorette and Bachelor in Paradise, had 2 left feet when he debuted in the ballroom with his messy quick step. He was still stuck at the bottom of the leaderboard in week two, but this was actually a big step up from opening night. His foxtrot scored 17 out of 30. He would have gotten 18, but Inaba docked him a point for an unauthorized lift. Actress Nancy McKeon wound up in the bottom two after Judge A's scores were combined with fewer votes last week, but once again she kept up with her esteemed pro partner Valch Murkowski, this time on a cha-cha, which got her 7s across the board for a total of 21. Harry Potter co-star Ivana Lynch was safe from elimination in week one, but she still returned to the dance floor with something to prove. Stingy Len Goodman gave her a 5 for her debut foxtrot. In week two, the producers gave her an even more difficult dance. The samba is notoriously tricky and has been kryptonite, even FFOR, the show's best contestants. But she not only improved on that 5, she got straight 8s from the panel for a total of 24, landing her in the top 5 for the night. See the complete judges' leaderboard below. Who do you think will be eliminated this time? It's a high-stakes game with a double elimination looming on Tuesday night. How fitting, then, that Tuesday is Las Vegas Night 1. Juan Pablo de Pace, 261. Milo Manheim, 261. Tinashe, 26-4. Alexis Ren, 25-5. Ivana Lynch, 24-5. DeMarcus Ware, 24-7. John Schneider, 23-8. Mary Lou Retton, 22-9. Nancy McKeon, 21-10. Bobby Bones, 20-11. Danelle Umstead, 18-12. Joa Mobile, 17.